Good morning. Today we'll move on to module 3. It is the steady magnetic field. It is lecture number 5. First we'll start with Biot-Savart's law. What Biot-Savart's law states is, before that we'll consider a current element, okay, because current element in the sense there is a current flowing through a thin filament of negligible radiance, okay, where suppose let us consider this is a thin filament where the current through this is, let us consider it is I, okay, and over this thin filament let us consider a differential element dl, okay, a small element differential length dl, okay. Now due to this differential element, where the current is flowing through this differential element is I, at some point P, okay, let us try to find out what is magnetic field intensity, okay. So Biot-Savart's law gives the magnetic field intensity at any point P due to this current element, which is written as I into dl, okay. It is written as I into dl, okay, this one. So what Biot-Savart's law states that the magnetic field intensity due to this current element is directly proportional to current element, okay. That is, magnetic field intensity is denoted by H. So differential magnetic field intensity due to this differential current element, the dH vector is directly proportional to current element I into dl. One more thing is, it is also directly proportional to sine of that angle between current element and the line joining the current element at point P. Okay, what it means is, so suppose if you take this is the current element, okay, and this is the line joining the current element and the point P, and the angle between these two lines, if you consider it as theta, then the current element will be directly proportional, sorry, magnetic field intensity is directly proportional to sine of the angle between this, okay. Then further, it is also inversely proportional to square of the distance between point P and the current element. In the sense, so if you take this is the distance from current element to point P, if you take it as vector r, then it is inversely proportional to square of the distance between this point P and the current element, this distance square, okay. Hence, by with these three statements, what can be said that the differential magnetic field intensity is proportional to current element multiplied by sine of the angle between the current element and the line joining the current element at point P, this is sine theta, divided by r square, where r is the distance between the current element and the point P, okay. R, so if you multiply this whatever the proportional by 1 by 4 pi, then we'll get the differential magnetic field intensity, that is dH vector will be equal to this I into dl cross unit vector ar cap divided by this r square, that is 4 pi r square, okay. So which will be equal to I into r, this can also be written as I into dl cross r vector, because what is ar cap? Ar cap is vector r divided by its magnitude, okay. So differential magnetic field intensity can be written as I into dl cross r cap divided by 4 pi r cube, okay. So hence the magnetic field intensity, the total magnetic field intensity can be written as line integral of this I into dl cross ar cap divided by 4 pi r square. Okay, that means if you consider a current element at some point P, what is the magnetic field intensity? Okay, if you take this is the current element and this is the point P, okay, at this point P, what is the magnetic field intensity is nothing but, suppose if you consider this is the point P and this is the angle theta, then it will be equal to, instead of stating it as I into dl sine theta by r square, this can be taken as I into dl cross ar cap, okay, because because this cross product in turn it gives you differential magnetic differential element magnitude multiplied by this unit vector magnitude, which is nothing but 1, multiplied by this sine of the angle between these two elements or the lengths. So hence it results back the same thing. So dl into sin theta is rewritten, or it is re-expressed as dl cross ar cap. Okay. So the magnetic field intensity will be integral I into dl cross ar cap divided by 4 pi r square. So this is the total magnetic field intensity, which is nothing but integral, it is the in line integral I into dl cross ar cap divided by 4 pi r square. Okay. This is the magnetic field intensity. Okay, so what we can recollect here is the electric field intensity will be there only whenever there is a point charges. Okay, but the magnetic field intensity will be there whenever we consider a current. If there is a current flows through the conductor, then we have a magnetic field intensity. So there exists a magnetic field intensity whenever there is a current flow through the conductor. Okay. So magnetic field intensity is expressed as line integral I into dl cross ar cap divided by 4 pi r square. And let us recollect one more thing. The current continuity equation, what we have come across in the module 2, that is divergence of J will be equal to minus dou rho v by dou t. Okay. J is the current density, rho v is the volume charge density. Okay. The charge density is not a function of time. Okay, so this charge density will not be a function of time. Hence, this divergence of J will be equal to zero. Or upon applying the divergence theorem, this del dot J will become zero. That means the volume integral can be written as surface integral. Okay, so hence surface integral J dot ds will be equal to zero, since we are telling divergence of J is zero. Okay. Further, this Biot-Savart's law can also be expressed in terms of current density J and surface current density K vector. Okay. So what is this surface current density means? Consider a surface. Okay. On that, if the current is flowing. Okay. Current is flowing. Then, if you consider a small element. Okay. Small length, which is, let us consider this is the small element, that is small length B, which is in the perpendicular direction to the current flowing. Okay, this length B is taken in the perpendicular direction to the current flow. Okay, then the current I within this length, the total current I can be written as the surface current density K multiplied by this length B. Okay, where the length B is perpendicular to the direction of the current. Okay, so the total current within this length B can be written as the surface current density, which is expressed in ampere per meter multiplied by length B. Yeah, where the total surface total current density total current can be expressed as line integral K into dn, where dn is the differential element of the path across which current is flowing. Okay, it is the differential element. Okay, it is a differential element of the path across which current is flowing. Okay, well, hence I into differential length vector can be written as this surface current density multiplied by the differential surface area, which will be equal to current density multiplied by the differential volume. Okay, extra what we have what we are doing here is we are everywhere we are multiplying by the differential length. Okay, so I into dl can be written, because I is nothing but K into L. Okay, so I into dl will become K into ds. Okay, and I is nothing but J into ds, but here extra length is there, so if you multiply it by the area multiplied by the length, it gives you the volume. Hence the magnetic field intensity in terms of the surface current density or current density can be written like this: H vector equal to surface integral K cross AR cap into ds divided by 4 pi r square. R magnetic field intensity can be written as volume integral j cross ar cap into differential volume divided by 4 pi r square. Okay, so we can express the current the magnetic field intensity due to current element in terms of idl, r in terms of k cross ar surface current, r magnetic field intensity due to current density j, okay, j cross ar into differential volume by 4 pi r square. Okay, so all these things we are deriving from the Biot-Savart's law, okay, where the Biot-Savart's law states these three proportionality. From there we have written this constant 4 pi, where we got this from using Biot-Savart's law, this magnetic field intensity. So we'll consider one problem here. Okay, given the following values for point P1 and point P2, and the differential current element is I1 into delta L1, calculate delta H2, where point P1 coordinates and point P2 coordinates are given, and the current element is equal to 2 pi az cap. Okay, where az cap is the direction of the current flow. Okay, we'll consider this first part A. The differential magnetic field intensity H2 is nothing but at some point P2 now. Okay, where point P1 may be on the current element, P2 is the point where we are finding the magnetic field intensity. So differential magnetic field intensity at point P2 will be equal to I into dl cross AR cap 1 to 2, okay, from point P1 to point P2, okay. So what is I into dl vector given in the problem? It is 2 pi az cap, okay, cross product with, we have to find out this unit vector AR cap 1 to 2, okay. This is point 1, this is point 2. 1 to 2 means 4 minus 0 ax cap plus 2 minus 0 ay cap plus 0 minus 2, it will become minus 2 az cap. Okay, so that gives you the vector r 1 to 2. Okay, but the unit vector will be magnitude of this vector divided by its magnitude. Okay, so then we have 4 pi r square. R square is nothing but magnitude of this whole square that we are substituting here. By substituting this unit vector and then magnitude square, we are getting this expression, where by substituting all those things and calculating, the differential magnitude vector at point P2 will be resulting as something like this: minus 8.51 ax cap plus 17 ay cap nano ampere per meter. Okay, what one thing we have to observe here is doing the cross product. Okay, az cross ax, okay, z cross x gives you nothing but y. Okay, then z cross y will result in minus ax cap. Okay, then z cross z is 0, so you will have only two vectors here. One is in y direction, one more is in the x direction, but z cross z will result in 0. Let us consider the point part B in this problem. What is the part B? Point P1 and point P2 has been given here, and the differential element is 2 pi az cap, same as the part A, but only thing is two points are different. Okay, so almost same thing, but only unit vector here it becomes 4 minus 0 ax cap, 2 minus 2 0, 3 minus 0 az cap. So you will have ax cap and az cap. Okay, so here you have 4 ax cap plus 3 az cap, y component becomes 0. Okay, then what is z cross x? Z cross x is nothing but y, but z cross z is 0, hence it is not written here, that is a 0. Okay, hence for this part B, answer will be 16 ay cap. Okay, similarly if you consider the part C, the problem here is point P1 is 1, 2, 3 and point P2 is minus 3, minus 1, 2. Okay, where the current element is 2 pi into minus ax cap plus ay cap plus 2az cap micro ampere per meter. Where the magnetic field intensity is nothing but 2 pi into this cross product with this unit vector. Okay, but here you have to do x cross this x, y, z, then y cross all these three, then z cross all these three, or it can be written in the form of a determinant as first row will be unit vector, second row will be the components of this vector, and third row will be the components of this vector. And by solving that, we get this one, okay, where the answer is differential magnetic field intensity at point P2 by calculating the magnitude and so on. The answer is 12.9 ax cap minus 33.9 ay cap plus 26.4 az cap nano ampere per meter. Further, we'll consider one more problem. Derive an expression for magnetic field intensity at any point due to an infinite long current carrying conductor. Okay, let us assume there is an infinitely long current carrying conductor. So let us place this infinitely long current carrying conductor along the z axis. Okay, let us assume this is placed along the z axis like this, from going from minus infinity to plus infinity, and let us assume the current is flowing in the increasing z direction, in this direction. At some point P, due to this current element, we have to find out the magnetic field intensity. Okay, so let us use the statement of the Biot-Savart's law. Using Biot-Savart's law, we'll try to find out the magnetic field intensity. So what is vector R12 here? So it is from here. If you consider here the current element, okay, if you consider here the differential current element, which is nothing but dl vector. So let us join this point to the point P, where we have to find out the magnetic field intensity, which will be equal to the vector R12, okay, from here to here, okay, from point, if this is the differential element and this is the point P, this direction, okay, this one, okay, this one, what is the vector R12, okay. So vector R12 is nothing but, it will be this one, this is nothing but rho a rho minus z a z cap, okay, because this length is z, so it will become vector R12 will become rho a rho cap minus z into a z cap, okay. Hence unit vector will become rho a rho cap minus z into a z cap. And divided by its magnitude would become rho square plus z square, root of rho square plus z square. Let the differential length vector will be equal to dz into az cap. Okay, this differential length vector will be equal to dz, because it is along the z direction. The small current element, this element will take it as dz, and current is flowing in z direction. So the vector is nothing but unit vector az cap. Hence, the differential magnetic field intensity at point 2 is nothing but at some point P. It is I into, this is differential length vector, I dz az cap cross product with, this is the unit vector ar cap, that is rho a rho minus z az, divided by its magnitude. Into 4 pi r square, okay, 4 pi r square will become rho square plus z square. Because of this, we have root of rho square plus z square. So combining that, it will become rho square plus z square whole power 3/2, okay. Where what is the total magnetic field intensity H2? H2 is nothing but, since the current is flowing from minus infinity to plus infinity, so we have to integrate from minus infinity to plus infinity this, okay, this one with respect to z we are integrating, okay. So if you integrate this, will become so if you, first thing is we have to take the cross product az cross rho, z cross rho will result in phi, but z cross z is 0. Okay, so we have only the, if the current is flowing along the z direction, the field intensity will be around it. Okay, that is what we can see here. The current is flowing in z direction and the magnetic field intensity in the phi direction. That means what you can imagine is, if the current is flowing in z direction, the field intensity will be around it. So further to integrate this, what can be done here is, we'll take some angle theta, okay, at the vertex where we have considered the current element. Let us consider this angle as theta. So if you take tan theta, opposite length is nothing but radial distance rho, and the adjacent length is nothing but z, okay, because the current element is considered at a height of z and the point P is taken at a length of rho. So because of that, tan theta is rho by z, r z will become rho into cot theta, and dz, if you differentiate this, dz will become minus rho. Cot theta differentiation is minus rho cosecant square theta d theta. Okay, so by substituting these things here, for the rho is nothing but z is nothing but rho into cot theta, and this dz is nothing but this minus rho cosecant square theta d theta. And then doing, we are simplifying, we'll get it as sin theta. Sin theta integration is nothing but minus cos, and integration from pi to 0. Okay, because here we have taken the differential length is from minus infinity to plus infinity. But, okay, see here, the current is flowing in this direction. We have taken the angle, this one, this is nothing but angle theta. Okay. So if you imagine, if you take if this theta goes to minus infinity, plus infinity, okay, if theta goes to plus infinity, it will become almost like a straight line. So angle will be nothing but it will become at plus infinity, it will become zero. Okay. Similarly, if you take, if you are going towards minus infinity, if you connect this to the point P, it will become almost like a straight line. So outside, the outside angle is nothing but theta, that will become straight line, nothing but the total angle will become 180 degree or nothing but the angle pi. Okay, hence, and the, if you integrating and substituting limit as pi to 0, the magnetic field intensity will be H2 vector will be equal to I by 2 pi rho A phi cap ampere per meter. Okay, so the magnetic field intensity is nothing but I by 2 pi rho. What you can observe here is the unit of magnetic field intensity is ampere per meter. Okay, so by, we are trying to solve this, trying to find the magnetic field intensity because of current carrying conductor, which is a infinite current carrying conductor, where the magnetic field intensity H2 vector will be equal to I by 2 pi rho A phi cap ampere per meter. Further, we'll consider one more problem, that is find the magnetic field intensity at any point in the vicinity of a straight current filament of finite length. Okay, where the differential magnetic field intensity vector using Biot-Savart's law, it is I into dl cross ar cap divided by 4 pi r square. Okay, what we are trying here is we have to find out the magnetic due to finite infinite. So further, same thing, infinite, okay, but is element, till here it is same thing as the previous one, okay, but since it is finite element, what can be substituted here is, okay, at one vertex where the current is starting to flow, that of the finite element, let us consider this from here to here is the finite element. At the beginning vertex, we consider the angle as theta I, which is the line joining from the starting point of current element to the point P, and the ending point of current element to the point P at this vertex will take the angle as theta final, theta F. Okay, so instead of integrating in the previous one from pi to 0, here the integration is from theta initial to theta final. Only that is the change, where the magnetic field intensity will result as I by 4 pi rho into cos theta final minus cos theta initial. So next we will take the third problem. It is find h vector at point P with coordinates 0.4, 0.30 in the field of a 8 amp filamentary current directed inward from infinity to origin on positive x axis and then outward to infinity along the positive y axis. Okay, so let us consider there is a current is flowing. Initially there is a 8 amp filamentary current. It is directed inward from infinity to origin on positive x axis. Okay, suppose if you consider this is the positive x axis, so current is flowing from positive x axis, okay, in this direction the current is flowing, and then it will flow outward along the y direction. Okay, it first flows along x direction and then it will flow outward in the y direction. Okay, at some point P where the point P coordinates are 0.4, 0.3 and 0. Okay, at this point P, due to the current flowing through x and then through y, we have to find out the field intensity at point P. Okay, so first we'll find out due to the current flowing through this element. Okay, what happens here is we have to find out the field intensity due to current flowing through the conductor x and then the current flowing through the conductor y. So first let us consider the, it is, we can call it as semi-finite semi-infinite conductor along x, same thing with respect to y conductor. Okay, so what is this theta initial? If you take theta initial due to the current flowing through the conductor x is nothing but, it will be nothing but, it will become total 180 degree. Okay, because this whole angle at infinity, this angle becomes 180 degree. But what is this theta final one? It is nothing but tan inverse of, okay, so you have this x direction, this is the point P, we have to take this direction, this one, I mean this length, and then the this perpendicular distance, the theta final is nothing but this length that is opposite divided by this adjacent. Okay, so adjacent is nothing but, it is 0.4, and the opposite is nothing but 0.3. so tan theta inverse will become, sorry, theta will become tan inverse of opposite length is 0.3 divided by this adjacent length is 0.4, because the point P is 0.4, 0.30. So this length will become 0.4, this length will become 0.3. okay, the same parallel distance, so this is 0.3. okay, so hence from the previous one we know what is the magnetic field intensity due to finite current element. It is I by 4 pi rho that we have got in the previous problem. It is I by 4 pi rho into cos theta final minus cos theta initial into a phi cap. Okay, so by using the same expression, it is I by 4 pi rho. What is rho? Rho is the perpendicular distance from point P to the current element. Okay, hence it will become high, what is that? It will be equal to 0.4. okay, so by substituting this I current element, the current is nothing but 8 divided by 4 pi rho into cos theta final minus cos theta initial. By using these values, okay, so this length is 0.3, that is nothing but rho, that is this length, okay, perpendicular distance, which is nothing but rho, 0.3. by substituting that cos theta final and cos theta initial values, this is cos theta final and this is the initial value, by substituting this we get something like 3.8. okay, still we haven't calculated the this unit vector which is there in cylindrical system. Let us try to express in Cartesian system. Okay, what is this a phi cap? It is, this is resulting due to the current flow direction cross product with unit vector in the direction from the current element to point P. okay, so what happens is current is flowing in minus ax cap and the unit vector is in the y direction, so it is minus ax cap cross ay cap. This is x cross y is nothing but az, so that is what we are getting here. So it is minus is retained as it is, x cross y is nothing but az cap. Okay, further we'll try to calculate what is the magnetic field intensity due to conductor y. okay, So what happens here is, again we have to find out what is the theta initial. Theta initial is this whole thing, okay, because this is the current element starting from origin to along y axis the current is flowing, okay. Hence we have to find out this whole thing is theta initial. That is nothing but this angle, which is 90 degree, plus this 36.87, this whole thing, 90 plus 36.87, that is the theta initial. But what happens to the theta final when this line joins at infinity? This angle, this theta final due to y conductor will become zero, okay. So theta initial is 90 plus 36, but theta final will be equal to zero, okay. Hence with these calculation, and what is rho here, I by 4 pi rho, what is rho here? Rho is nothing but it is equal to this distance, this distance, this distance is nothing but 0.4, okay. So hence we are getting here it as, by doing this calculation we are getting it as 2.54. but what is the current direction here? It is ay cap, okay. And what is the unit vector direction? It is ax cap. So y cross x will result in minus az cap, okay. So hence the total magnetic field intensity is magnetic field intensity due to current flowing through x conductor and the field intensity due to current flowing through y conductor. That is, adding this minus 3.82 and minus 2.54, both are in az cap direction. Hence the total field intensity is minus 6.36 az cap ampere per meter. Further, we'll consider next one more problem. A current filament carrying a 15 amps in az cap direction lies along the entire z axis. Find the magnetic field intensity in rectangular coordinates at point P with the coordinates 20, 0, 4. Okay, we'll consider this problem first. Okay, so let us assume the current is flowing in x, z direction, okay, at some point P with coordinates 20, 0, 4. We, at this point P, we have to find out what is magnetic field intensity. Okay, so what is this? First we have to find out, let us consider a small current element here on this conductor, a thin filament, where if you try to take a perpendicular distance from point P to this differential element, the coordinates will become 0, 0, 4. Okay, hence if you take this vector or the perpendicular distance, it will become root of 20, okay, where unit vector a phi cap is nothing but differential length, the current direction in az cap, direct multiple cross product with unit vector in this direction, okay. So hence the magnetic field intensity is nothing but, due to infinite current carrying conductor, we know it is I by 2 pi rho into a phi cap, okay. So it becomes 15, it is given here, divided by 2 pi into rho, rho is nothing but root 20 into a phi cap. What is a phi cap? It is nothing but az cross product with ar cap. But what is ar cap? Unit vector ar cap is nothing but it is root 20 minus 0, 0 minus 0, 4 minus 4, so it becomes 0. So it will become root 20 into ax cap, okay. So we have only unit vector we want, so it will become root 20 ax cap divided by root 20, so it will become only ax cap, okay. So then this ar cap is nothing but ax cap, differential length vector is nothing but az cap, okay. Z cross x is nothing but ay cap, okay. And by doing this numerical values calculation, we get it as 0.53 a phi cap ampere per meter, okay. Further, we'll move on to this part B. The part B is, some other point is given with coordinates 2 comma minus 4 comma 4, okay. What change here we have to do is, one is we have to find out what is this unit vector, okay. So if you take unit vector, anyway that z component will not come, it will become 2 minus 0 minus 4 minus 0, okay. So it will become 2 ax cap minus 4 ay cap, okay. And the magnitude of this will become root 20, okay. And rho is also nothing but root 20. So by substituting this I, and row value and doing z cross x. Z cross x is nothing but ay, and z cross y is nothing but minus ax. Okay, so minus into minus, it will result here as plus. So we get something like 4.476 ax cap plus 0.238 ay cap ampere per meter. Okay, further we'll take one more problem. That is, find the magnetic field intensity at the center of a circular wire of radius a meters carrying a current of I amperes in z equal to 0 plane. Let us consider this figure. Okay, there is a current element which is in the form of a circular ring. Okay, let us consider this is placed in z equal to 0 plane. Okay, at this origin, okay, where the center of this circle is nothing but the origin. So let us try to find out what is the field intensity at this point P due to this current carrying element. Okay, the current is flowing, let us consider the current is flowing in this direction due to this current carrying circular ring. At origin or at the center, we have to find out the field intensity. Okay, so we will take the center or the origin, which is the point P, as 0, 0, 0. At this point, we have to find out the field intensity. Okay, so according to the Biot-Savart's law, we know differential magnetic field intensity is nothing but I into dl cross ar cap divided by 4 pi r square. Okay, so what all we have to find here is the differential length dl and the unit vector ar are the radius, are the length r cap, r vector. Okay, so it becomes, what is the differential length? The differential length here in this figure, you can see the differential length in this direction. Okay, so let us consider the radius of this circular ring is a. Okay, so the differential length here, if you take this angle as angle phi and the differential angle as d phi, this arc is nothing but differential length will be equal to a into d phi. Okay, so if this is the radius r and we have taken here the differential length and this is nothing but the differential angle, this arc will be equal to, this arc will be equal to this differential length nothing but a multiplied by this angle d phi. Okay, so this differential length will be equal to this radius a multiplied by this angle. Okay, so differential length will be equal to a into d phi and the current flowing is I. Okay, then we have to find out the vector in this direction. The vector in this direction, it is taken as a origin to point P. Okay, what is that vector? It is nothing but, the vector r is nothing but minus a into arrow cap. Okay, because since we have taken a circular ring, the current, it is flowing in this circular ring in this direction. Okay, unit vector from origin to point P, it is in the radial direction. Okay, which can be taken as arrow cap. So vector r is nothing but minus a into arrow cap. Okay, so this vector r from point from the current element to point P, it will be in this direction. It will be in this direction, which is nothing but a into arrow. Okay, so by substituting those things, so it is nothing but minus a into arrow cap. So where this arrow cap, if you try to express in the form of a Cartesian, it will be different. Okay, before that, the differential magnetic field intensity I into dl, what is dl? Just now we have got, it is nothing but a into d phi. Okay, and the current flowing direction is nothing but a phi cap. The current is in this form, it is a circular ring. If the current is flowing in a phi cap, okay, so it is a phi cap cross product with a rho cap. Okay, phi cross rho is nothing but z. Okay, hence it results as differential magnetic field intensity as I into d phi divided by 4 pi a. Okay, what is this? R square is nothing but a square. Okay, because that is the radial distance from point P to the origin. That is the radius of the conductor also. Okay, so differential magnetic field intensity vector will be equal to I d phi by 4 pi a z cap. So what one thing we can observe here is the current is flowing in phi direction, then the field intensity will be in the z direction. Okay. But what is the total magnetic field intensity? Let us try to find out from this differential field. We'll find out the total field. Before that, let us try to formulate this problem also in the Cartesian. Okay. So for the Cartesian, this unit vector arrow cap, let us consider if it is in the z direction, it can be written as minus a into az cap plus z into az cap. So phi cross phi cross rho and phi cross z will be resulting in I a square az cap, because phi cross rho is nothing but z. But phi cross z is nothing but you will be getting a rho component. But what happens is, if you consider in the opposite vertex, okay, if you take diagonally opposite conductors, okay, the current through this will be in this direction. Current through here, it will be in this direction. Okay, because of this, the current element, the magnetic field intensity will be in this direction at point P. Okay, because of this element, magnetic field intensity will be in this direction. Okay. This radial component and this radial component, they are in opposite direction, which will get cancelled. Okay, so further, the total magnetic field intensity will have only the magnetic field intensity only along z direction. Okay, hence the total magnetic field intensity is integral 0 to 2 pi, because phi is nothing but it is from 0 to 2 pi, it is full circle. Okay. So, which will be resulting as I into a square az cap divided by 2 into a square plus z square whole power 3 by 2. Okay. Or further, for a semicircular ring, the magnetic field intensity will become I divided by 4a into az cap ampere per meter. Okay. So, the total magnetic field intensity, if you consider here, this is nothing but it becomes 2 pi, so it becomes I divided by 2a. Okay, the total field intensity due to a circular ring is I by 2a. Okay, whereas for a semicircular ring, it becomes I by 4a. Further, we'll consider one more problem, that is, find magnetic field intensity at some point P. Okay, where the conductors are given something like this. There is a filament along A to B, something like a semicircle, then B to C, there is a straight line conductor, then you have a filament C to D, then D to A, again three filaments. Okay, so totally three straight filaments are there and one semicircular ring. At this point P, we have to find out the what is magnetic field intensity. Okay, so first thing is, we'll try to find out due to this semicircular ring what is the magnetic field intensity. Okay, so that is magnetic field intensity at point P due to this element A to B, which is a semicircular ring. We know field intensity is nothing but I by 4a. Okay, and the field intensity, if you take in this direction, okay, let us assume it is in the az cap direction. Okay, then, and the length from here to here, the length is nothing but here it is given 5 centimeter. So it becomes I divided by 4a. A is nothing but it is 5 centimeter multiplied by the current direction. The current is flowing in this direction. Okay. So cross product with this unit vector, which may result in minus az cap. Okay. So, which is where the answer is coming, it as the current is nothing but it is equal to 10 amps divided by this, will be resulting in minus 50 az cap ampere per meter. Okay. What the assumption here, it is taken as this is y and this length will be in the x direction. Okay. Then, the field intensity due to the element BC, it can be written as, due to this is a finite element, so it is I by 4 pi rho into cos theta final minus cos theta initial. Okay, what is cos theta final here? We have to join this point directly here, So this angle will be theta initial, which is nothing but 90 degree. And if we join this point here, this angle will be theta initial, this line, okay. Then we have to find out this theta initial, where theta initial, it has been given here, it is equal to tan inverse of opposite divided by adjacent, okay. What is opposite? Opposite is nothing but this length. This total length is 10 centimeter, half of that will be 5 centimeter. So tan inverse of phi divided by adjacent, okay. So this is opposite divided by this adjacent. So which is nothing but 5 by 10, okay. So which is resulting as 26 degree, and cos theta initial will be nothing but 90 degree. So this results as 26 and 90 degree as theta final and theta initial respectively, okay. And so what is this unit vector direction? It is the direction of the current flow cross product with the unit vector, okay. What is the current flow direction? Current flow is in the minus y direction, because this length, this direction is taken as minus y. So this is minus y, and the unit vector direction, unit vector direction is in the positive x axis, because this is taken as positive x axis, okay. So it is minus ay with this positive x axis, okay. So it is minus ay with minus ax cap, which will be resulting in az cap, okay. So where the answer is so much. Then the field intensity due to the current element cd. What is cd here? This is the current element cd. So we have to find out theta initial, this angle, already there it is 26 degree, and this theta final, this angle, okay. That angle can be calculated as tan inverse of this length opposite divided by this adjacent, okay. So doing that, which has been shown here, so where the cos theta final will be getting it as 63 degree, and cos theta initial is nothing but 90 plus 26 degree, which will be resulting as minus 7.12 az cap, okay. Similarly, current element due to dA is nothing but, if we join this point here, we have to find out this theta initial and this theta final, okay. So the theta initial and theta final is coming as 90 degree and 90 plus 63, okay. So this whole angle, okay, from this line to this line, if you join this point here, this whole angle, okay. So it is 90 plus 63. So doing that calculation, it's coming as around minus 14 az cap, okay. Hence, by adding all these current due to, I mean the field due to all these four elements, the total field intensity at point P will be around 85.5 az cap ampere per meter. Further, let me consider one more problem, that is, find the magnetic field intensity at this center O of a square of a side equal to 5 meter and carrying a 10 ampere of current, okay. So there is a square which is carrying a 10 ampere of current, okay, and their side is equal to 5 meter, okay. At the center O, at the center O, we have to find out the magnetic field intensity or the magnetic flux density, okay. So consider the differential element along AB of a square, where differential length is dx into ax cap, okay. So on this conductor, let us consider a small differential length, which let us consider it as dx, okay, because this axis is taken as x and this is taken as y, okay. That means this current element is placed along xy plane, which is in the form of a square, okay. So the vector r12 joining the differential element at point P is minus x ax cap minus y ay cap, okay. That is, if you take here this point P can be something like x comma y, okay. So which will become, if you take at this towards this one, it will become 0 minus x, 0 minus y. So it will become minus x minus y ax cap and ay cap, okay. So what is the magnitude? So it becomes root of x square plus y square, and the unit vector is this vector divided by its magnitude. So further, the differential length cross product with the unit vector, okay, the current is flowing along the x direction, okay, and this unit vector is nothing but minus x minus y. So if you calculate this cross product, answer is minus y dx az cap, okay. So according to Biot-Savart's law, the magnetic field intensity is, we know, I into dl cross ar divided by 4 pi r square, okay. Hence it will be equal to, if you substitute all this, anyway it is there, differential length and the magnitude and the unit vector, by substituting this we are getting this answer, that is 10 into minus 2.5 dx az cap divided by this, okay. Yeah, further, so this current element is there over a length from 2.5 to minus 2.5, or you can write it as it is 2 times of 2.5 to 0, because there are two current elements along the x direction, okay. So and then we have to find out what is this length x, okay, where the length x can be written as 2.5 into tan theta, okay. But what is theta, we have to find out, okay. So here this length is nothing but, here the current element is of side equal to 5 meter, okay. So where this side, this length, we have to find out this angle theta, okay, where the angle theta, where x is nothing but, you can write it as 2.5 tan theta, or if you differentiate this, it will become dx equal to 2.5 into secant square theta d theta, okay. The limit, when you substitute x equal to 2.5, this angle theta will become 45 degree, or when you substitute this limit as x equal to 0, this angle theta will become 0 degree, okay. By doing, substituting these things and then doing the integration, so it becomes simplifying 1 by secant theta, and then doing 1 by secant is nothing but cos, integration of cos is nothing but sine, and substituting the limits, we get around 0.45 az cap ampere per meter, okay. This is the field intensity due to a current element, okay. But there are something similar to this, there are 4 current elements, so because of which the total magnetic field intensity is nothing but 4 into this, so the H total will be equal to 4 into H, which will be resulting in 1.8 az cap ampere per meter, okay. So this is the magnetic field intensity, okay. So I'll stop at this point, okay. Further we'll consider similar to this more problem in a revision class.